Vim's keystrokes are hard to memorize. The steep learning curve can be flattened by understanding the natural logic behind the keys in normal mode and their actions. This tutorial is based on an old blog post that I present here to the right for your convenience. I'll also link to it below. Everything we'll see in this video are normal mode commands. You can run them also in insert mode by using the Control O and then the command itself, which will execute and go back to insert mode. So without further ado, let's learn Vim with logic rather than memory. Lowercase a will append text after the cursor, and capital A will append text after the line. You can see here I'm using small a to just append the character and then go back to normal mode, or I can use capital A and start writing when the line ends. A also stands for around, so I can do actions in an area and I can do actions around an area. For example, here I'm doing something in the bracket of the functions, but if I do it around the bracket of the functions, it takes the code in it and with the brackets themselves. Look at the difference. B stands for backwards or beginning. Lowercase b moves backward a word, and capital B moves a big word. I've mapped capital B to go to the beginning of the line, but you can do the same with just hitting zero. Note how I just jump backwards through the words or go to the beginning of the line with the capital one. There is a very fine detail with using zero where you go before the text when you hit it, so it before the line starts. C stands for change, usually in or around the motion, or change from here if you're using the capital C. So if I were to change in a word, like here on echo, I'm removing echo and going directly into insert mode. But when I do it in the brackets of the function, I change everything within the brackets and I can immediately start typing again. I can also hit change in paragraph, which in this case will change the entire paragraph from here up, because there is a straight continuity of lines from the beginning of the document to where my cursor was. D is for delete. Delete in Vim is not actually deleting, but deleting to an unnamed register, meaning you can repaste whatever you've just deleted. I can delete something like around the word or around the paragraph or in a word or in a line, but I can also use capital D or DD to delete a line. That's a very useful shortcut in Vim. With capital D, I'm deleting from here on forward, so from where my cursor is at to the end of the line. Doing the same with the capital C yields the same result, only in this case I'm staying in normal mode. I can of course use any other motion in Vim, like delete to the end of the document or delete to the beginning of the document with capital G or GG. E stands for end. I'm going to the end of the word, and like with B, I've mapped my capital E to go to the end of the line. So I can actually move with either W, that we'll touch on in a bit, which is moving to another word, or to the end of the next word. With F, I can find a character or use the opposite, capital F, to find backwards. So if I were to find W, I can jump to the next W that I find. I can find backward A or find backward W or find backward whatever other character I want. The nice thing with find is that you can use semicolon to go to the next result. You see here I have multiple A's, so I can search for A and do that, or use comma to search backwards with the same result. G is used to go to. I mainly use Shift G and GG to go to the beginning of the document or the end of it, but you can go to in a number of the lines you want to move, and that's also useful in sometimes. I is a very important keystroke in Vim. It changes to insert mode from normal mode. So insert would actually start typing from the current cursor and on, or I can use capital I to start writing at the beginning of the word. Wherever you are, you can just type capital I and it'll jump straight to the beginning of the word and start typing. It's also useful because I can use some kind of a visual mark and change everything within a number of lines. We'll touch on visual marks and their functionality when we get to V. Markers are an extremely useful feature of Vim, where I can put checkpoints inside the document and save them to a register. So if I type MA, I'm marking something, the current line, to the register A. And then with single quote A, I can jump back straight to the same line. I can save any mark to any type of register on my keyboard. N is used to go to the next result. Capital N is the opposite of it, meaning searching backwards. So if I were to search for a high, H-I, I can go to the next result with N, and that's a circular result, meaning if I get to the last result, I'll jump straight back to the beginning of the document. If I use capital N, it works the same way, just in reverse order. Opening a line is a way to save keystrokes by starting a new line below and going into insert mode, rather than using the arrows and starting in insert mode. So I can use O to start a new line below the cursor, or use capital O to go above the line I'm currently at. P is used to paste things we've cut or copied, or use paragraph as an endpoint to an action. For example, here I've used DIP to delete in paragraph. Lowercase p will paste under the cursor, while capital P will paste above it. Let's see that again. I'm copying the line, pasting it each time below, or I can copy something and paste it before the cursor. Macros are an extremely useful feature of Vim. It may be too big to cover here in just a few seconds, but I'll do my best. So Q lets me start record some kind of a series of function. Here I'm recording to the Q register, that's the easy one because hitting QQ just does that. And I'm doing a set of actions, and then when I'm done, I hit Q again to stop recording, and I can rerun the same macro with at Q. So I've just added a bunch of echo hello here just to showcase. This feels like it deserves a video of its own to go through properly. Let me know if you think the same in the comments below. The most common use of R is with capital R to constantly replace something under the cursor. I can replace a single character with the smaller R, or I can move back and use capital R, and until I'm stopping, I can constantly change all the characters. S is used to switch either a character and moving on into insert mode, or switching the entire line. To be completely honest, that's one of the least keystrokes I'm using in Vim because I can cover with C or D or any other keystroke that helps. You can see how capital S just deletes the line and goes into insert mode regardless of where my cursor is. T is an important motion action in Vim. It goes to a character or goes backward to a character if you're using the capital version of it. So if I'm using to a certain character, whether that's visual marking to a character or deleting to a character or changing to a character, I'm doing it with to, and that brings me to the character that I'm looking for. And again, I can do the opposite with the capital T. U is for undo. Capital U redoes all the actions in a certain line. I think it's too complex to explain and I'm not using it myself, but just know that it exists. Undo is probably one of the more useful functions wherever or whichever IDE you're using. V is for visual selection, and it's our way to visually select either a line, a paragraph, a chunk of code in the IDE. So I can just visually mark and go down to mark a set of characters or lines. I can use capital V to mark the entire line, or use control V to vertically select any kind of visual block that I like. With W, I can go to the next word or mark some kind of word. With capital W, I'm marking the entire word, like a big word, meaning any set of characters that are separated by a space rather than just a set of letters. X just stands for deleting a character, a pretty simple motion that I'm using to delete a certain character or a single one when that's required. Yanking is Vim copying. You can obviously yank in or around something. Something can be a paragraph, in brackets, around a paragraph, inline, etc., etc. Capital Y is yanking the entire line, and then you can paste it, delete it, whatever you want to do. That's one of the more useful motions in Vim. Z is used for two main things. One is centering the view around where the cursor is currently at, which is very useful. And the other one is managing faults of code in Vim. Faults are your way to fold the code into a single line and then expand it back again when you want to view the entire core with Android. You can also Shift Z twice to exit the document while saving it. Pretty useful just as well. You can find the blog post right here on my website and the notebook that I use to add Vim notes as I find them in my Vim notebook on GitHub. And if you're interested in my TMUX setup, be sure to watch the video on that from last week, or the one with how I set up Neovim with Vim Fugitive and everything around Git management. Bye-bye.